Big thanks to Kamada Joe for sponsoring this episode.
You've asked me to make more videos about how to cook on a barbecue. Barbecue techniques, that's what you want, so that's what you get. So here it is. This is all you need to know. If you know these four basic barbecue techniques and you master them, you will be able to cook anything you want on a barbecue. That's it. I'm giving you all my secrets. What do you think the four basic techniques of barbecue are?
My guess is, well, it's definitely grilling. And I'm talking about steaks.
Grilling.
Yeah, grilling.
Pork chops.
Full heat.
Yes.
So after that, it's, I'm gonna say low and slow, but that's not low and slow, it's smoking.
Smoking.
Only smoking. Now my head is running on empty.
All right. I think that's a good reason to make this video alone.
No. Let me think. Smoking, grilling. The other day we made a video about chicken and you started about roasting.
Roasting.
But I don't get the difference.
Let's get into it.
I got three now. So there's another one. What's the other one?
I'm not gonna tell you.
Come on, man.
The other one is cooking on a low temperature. A really, really low temperature. Well, cold smoking.
So that's lower than
we're gonna go as low as you can go. We're gonna go all the way limbo. I'm gonna explain everything.
Okay.
Don't worry, I got you. So the first technique that I'm gonna talk about is cold smoking, and I'm gonna show it to you on the Kamada Joe. But all of these techniques apply to every charcoal grill in the world. If your grill has any form of insulation like the Kamada Joe, you want to take that out. These are ceramic plates, they gotta go. We want the grill to have as little insulation as you can. So these are gonna go, and all we're gonna be left with is a cold steel grill with cold steel grill grates. Remove any type of fuel that you might have in your grill. Clear it of charcoal and ashes, because if you're gonna light that up, it's just gonna catch fire and be energy. And energy means warmth. And since we're talking about cold smoking, I don't wanna go over a temperature of 24 degrees Celsius. I'm going to start a small fire made out of charcoal, but I'm going to start it outside my barbecue. And all I need is a handful of charcoal. I'm going to light that up with a fire starter, set it on fire, and I'm gonna wait until my charcoal is fully lit up. Now that I got my charcoal lit up, I'm just gonna pick one piece, because this is fuel and this is generating heat, and I want as little heat as I can possibly have in my barbecue. Now I'm gonna carefully drop this in without dropping it down all the way to the bottom. So now that I got my heat source, I'm also going to need smoke wood. So now you got a lot of options. For instance, you can use these fine smoke chips, like super, super fine, and they give off a lot of smoke. These you can use, except for the problem is they would drop down in the grill and they're gone. Another option is to use wood chunks. In my case, a big chunk of firewood, but this is also a lot of fuel, and a lot of fuel means a lot of heat. So what we're gonna use is this. These are wood chips and they are soaked in water, which means they are wet and take up a lot of energy from the fire to start smoking, but also take away from the heat. That's why we call it cold smoking. Low energy, no heat. Now I'm going to add these wood chips to the charcoal. And this might seem a little odd. We're just using so little. If you master this and you understand what's happening here, you can cold smoke in any season. Now that we got a little smoke production, we're gonna put in the grill grates. And now these small twirls of smoke are just coming up. We're gonna close the lid and we're going to close the top vent, but we're gonna keep a rather large gap on top because we want the air to flow. We need the air to flow because we have so little fuel inside that once we close this down too much, fire's going to die down, the energy is gone, and we're not gonna have any smoke. And you might think, hey, that's very little smoke. Is it even going to smoke? Yes. Cold smoking is mostly done over more than 4 hours. So a little twirl of smoke is going to build up in the dome and it's going to create one big bubble of smoke. Now, if you think you're in trouble and you think the temperature might rise over that 24 degrees Celsius, here's a trick to lower the temperature. Add in a tray and add some cold energy. Could be cold water or even ice cubes if you want. And here again, we're talking about energy balance. If you got that small bulb of energy created by the charcoal and the wood, and it's getting more energized and energized, but it's being too much for your grill and the circumstances that you're in and the temperature's rising, you need energy to balance that out. Cold water, ice cubes, and then you can have a perfectly controlled environment to cold smoke it. You can use the cold smoke technique to make the most beautiful things. Just think of it. Smoked salmon. Cold smoked salmon. We all know how good that is. What do you think of your own smoked sea salt? Or smoked spices, smoked paprika, smoked pimento. I'm thinking nuts, I'm thinking salt, I'm thinking salmon, I'm thinking cheese, I'm thinking sausages, I'm thinking everything. I'm thinking everything you eat cold. That's what it's limited to. Everything. Oh, you could even cold smoke your drink. Did you know that? Cold smoke your whiskey. Master this technique and it's all gonna be yours. The second basic barbecue technique is smoking, low and slow smoking. So I'm talking about temperatures from 24 degrees and up, all the way to 140 degrees Celsius. I'm gonna show you how to do it on the Kamado Joe Kettle Joe, but this goes for any charcoal grill. You start setting up this basic technique by adding charcoal to your grill. Now, of course, we're gonna add more than with cold smoking because now actually we want heat in our barbecue. Before we light up our charcoal, we need to talk about the fact that not every charcoal barbecue is the same. This is the Kamado Joe Kettle Joe and it has ceramic plates to deflect the heat and keep the warmth inside the grill. If you got a kettle grill set up, you got the slow roller set up from Kamado Joe, or you got a ceramic grill, or even an ugly drum smoker, it doesn't matter. What we are talking about is the amount of energy. You might need to put in a heat deflector, you might need to bank it to one side, but what counts is the amount of heat that you're adding to your barbecue and the amount of heat that you're adding to your food. Now, I have a whole video talking about radiation heat and convection heat. So check that out just to make sure you understand what we're talking about. But now I'm gonna show you how we can control the temperature just with the amount of charcoal that we have. So let's light this charcoal up just with a fire starter on one side. What we wanna do here is create a fire that we're going to let slowly walk from one side of the grill to the other side of the grill, burning that charcoal low and slow. When you use this technique, you're never gonna unleash all of the power of charcoal at the same time. It's just gonna burn up slowly and make sure that you're able to control the temperatures in your barbecue. I hear a lot of people talking about, whoa, the temperature's too high, how do I slow it down? They close the vents and it works, but it just takes a long time. You wanna start slow with a small fire and a low amount of charcoal. Remember, you can always add more charcoal when the temperature's too low. That's very easy. But taking out charcoal that's actually lit up is going to be much harder and it's much easier and riskier to overcook your meat that way. Now that our charcoal is lit up, it can go on burning for a longer period of time, and that's what we're looking for when we're smoking low and slow. We want to cook for many, many hours. And of course, you need smoke wood to smoke at a low and slow temperature. And you can probably already imagine that small chips and small pieces of smoke wood are not gonna give us a long period of smoke. No, what we need is big chunks of smoke wood that can burn for a longer period of time and smoke for a longer period of time. You're just gonna set it over the charcoal and let it burn together with the charcoal, producing a beautiful low smoke profile. And depending on how much smoke you actually want, you can add more chunks. So while my charcoal is burning, it hits a chunk of smoke wood, produces smoke flavor, it keeps on burning, hits another chunk and another chunk. That way you can have smoke flavor throughout the whole cook. So you got your grill lit up, you got your smoke wood settled. Now you wanna set it up for barbecuing. With this barbecue, we can add the slow roller. This is a big ring that I can set onto my barbecue in which I can place my grill grates is creating that indirect heat, because that's important. When you're cooking low and slow at a temperature between 24 and 140 degrees Celsius, you want indirect heat. No matter if you got a kettle grill and you're using a block of firewood to prevent radiation heat coming onto your meat, or you use a heat deflector or a slow roller like this, make sure you got indirect heat. This is the most desired technique that there is in barbecue, the low and slow. It is the epitome of everything. It's what we use to make brisket, ribs, pulled pork, everything, smoked sausage. All of the good stuff that comes off a barbecue is smoked. Smoked at a temperature between somewhere of 24 degrees to 140 degrees Celsius. So if you see that meat that's juicy, that's tender, and it's cooked all the way to pull, or all the way to just about the pull, with a beautiful crust, an immense amount of smoke flavor, and a beautiful smoke ring on the outside, that's what this does. That's what it's for. Now we're getting to the third technique, roasting. And this is the easiest technique that there is in all of barbecue. But at the same time, it's the technique that reminds you the least of barbecuing. To set it up, all you need to do is add charcoal to your barbecue. As you can see, we're using a lot more charcoal than with the other two techniques. We need that amount of charcoal to generate enough heat to get to roasting temperatures of 140 until 180 degrees Celsius. We're going to start this charcoal up by using not one, not two, but three fire starters. We want the whole pile to be fully lit up. I've got all my fans open. I've got everything rolling at maximum. We need energy, we need power. Now our barbecue is fully lit. The charcoal is generating its maximum amount of energy. Then we have full combustion. All of that fuel is being burned. We've got hot, clean air. The good thing about hot, clean air is that it burns beautiful and it crispens up the outside of the meat. But the downside to this beautiful, clean burn is that you don't have smoke. Now, if I would have added smoke wood to this, it would just burn because of the high temperatures and the high amount of heat. So when you're roasting, don't add smoke wood. And now you understand that roasting in a barbecue is the closest to cooking indoors, because whether you're roasting in a barbecue or in an oven, you got hot, clean air. It just comes from a different heat source. And with roasting, we cook indirect heat again. So it depends on the barbecue that you're using, what that actually looks like. But in this case, I could add a heat deflector and a grill grate. If you're using a kettle grill, again, you can use a shield to separate the hot charcoal from an area that's indirect heat. But indirect heat is the basis of using this technique. Every setup goes as long as you're blocking the radiation heat and you're only using convection heat. When you think of wonderful things to cook, you're thinking of prime rib roast, you're thinking of a crust, you're thinking of meat that's succulent on the inside, but crunchy and crispy on the outside. That's what this technique does. It makes your meat juicy because it cooks the meat, and then on the outside, the hot air crunches everything up and makes everything crispy. And then once you sink your teeth into it, it blows your mind. Rib roast, tri-tips, picanhas, all the better roasts are roasted on these temperatures with these techniques. And the fourth and final basic barbecue technique is grilling. And it's super, super easy to set up because it's just like roasting, except it's direct. So just take out the heat deflector or the object that's blocking your direct heat to hit the meat and just use your grill as it is. Now, of course, you got all kinds of variants to that, but this is what it is. You create a bed of charcoal and you put a grill grate on top of that, and then you're gonna be searing. Now, roasting might be the farthest thing from barbecuing, grilling is more pure and essential. You got direct contact with the flames and direct contact with the heat, creating a beautiful crust on your meat. But at the same time, the fat's rendering down and is giving that meat a flame-kissed feeling and a flame-kissed flavor. That's why people love grilling so much. It's a part of barbecue that develops flavor in a way that you otherwise wouldn't have. Morrison, you think this is gonna be enough for the two of us? And if you don't, I got another one. Just to make sure, if you're hungry, because I know that damn dog's around here somewhere, just lurking in the shade, waiting for us to be done with our steak. Grilling, the all-beloved grilling. The way my ancestors cooked, the way your ancestors cooked. Everything was grilled back in the days. And the reason why we grilled it, because it's the most fabulous thing ever. Forget all the other technique. This is the one. If you master it, it's gonna blow your mind. With the perfect amount of distance between the flames and the grill grates, you're gonna crunch up the outside. Still, your meat is gonna be juicy and tender. You're gonna have that little char that's gonna give that hint of bitterness, which makes your meat taste fantastic. Grilling. Grilling steaks, grilling chicken wings, grilling pork steaks, pork chops, grilling fish, grilling everything. Man, grilling is just the best.
Which one do you love best?
Man, that's like choosing between your children.
Yes, which is the best child?
What's the best way, in my opinion, to cook a steak? It's indirect and then sear it off. So you already need both of them.
But then, what do you do the most? Which technique?
Searing. On my own barbecue at home?
Yeah.
Just searing off. Just this old school grilling. No, it's not. I don't have a favorite.
Oh, come on. I love all these techniques. But if you master these techniques and you're not the expert just yet, but how close are you to mastering these techniques that you nail them every time?
Nowhere near. No, because there's always room for mistakes and they keep on happening, but that's okay. It's about how you deal with it, I think.
That's it. Now you heard it, guys. You gotta work it. You gotta master all these four techniques to cook, because if you need to save something, if you're roasting and then just trying to flip it up, you gotta go low and slow, you gotta grill it, or you gotta smoke it first and you grill it with a reverse sear technique of a steak.
Yeah.
There's so many things you can do with it, so you just gotta play around.
As long as it's not black, you still gotta eat it and then learn from it.
Yeah. If it's black, you can throw it at someone.
But before that point, you gotta eat it and respect it.
I think all the sensible stuff in this video is already passed.
Yeah.
We just gotta say, hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you like these technique videos, we gotta know about it.
Yeah, if you want to learn more, he doesn't shut up about it, so.
Thank you very much. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you want to see me knocking in Morrison's face, go to our OnlyFans page, what's it called? Fans Only page, and you'll see me wrestling Morrison. See you guys next time. Until then.
Eet smakelijk.
And keep on grilling.